My respected ulama, teachers, ustadu ulama, colleagues, classmates, brothers and sisters in Islam, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. First of all, I'd like to welcome the teachers who are amongst us today and at the zenith of this mafil. We have the Chief Executive Hazrat Allama Mona Tuqi Ishaq Sahab. We have the Brigadier General Nadeem Qamar Sahab. We have Al-Haj Badi Yaqub, Al-Haj Fazilatul Shaykh Mona Muzaffar, and Al-Haj Al-Dr. Fufaji, and Sister Lainun as well. And before we start the mafil, I would just like to call up to say at the front amongst us is our Lupe and our future ulama this year of the ulama Sunnah this year, and who are the pioneers amongst the students of Hijaz College. So I'd like them to come forward. Kabir Amdad Sahib and Umar Zaq Sahib, Hamza Sahib, Suhail Sahib, and they are pushing me to
قریب کی بات ہے ना कहीं से दूर है मंजिले, ना कोई करीब की बात है, जिसे चाह अब जिसका नाद दे, ये दरे हबीब की बात है, जिसे चाह दर पे बुला लिया,
has been trying to get all the brothers in together. The adab of a mahfil is that you come close together, because in between the shaitan sits down. So you're in the mahfil of Muharram and the shaitan is between you guys. So if all the brothers can come together, Allahumma salli ala sayyidina wa maulana wa ala alihi wa sahbihi. My brothers, there are many other speakers here. I'm not going to waste that much time of yours, but all I want to talk about today is that Muharram and how it's related to the Muslim Ummah today. Muharram, the 10th of Muharram, the day what happened.
He actually said to him, he said, look, I know what your problem is. Your problem is you thought that you should have been Khalifa, the head. So look, why don't we do this? I'll make you the head of any province of the Islamic State. How about that? I'll cut you a deal. You accept what I say, and I will make you a governor of any state. Imam Hussein said, no, sorry, no interest. Said, okay, I know what the thing is. You want some money, isn't it? How about I slip you a few thousand gold coins? So you'll be a multi-millionaire. So what do you think Imam Hussein said to him? He said to Yazid, do you not know whose grandson I am? That when the leaders of Makkah said, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we will give you anything you desire, do you not know what my grandfather said? That if you put the sun in my right hand, the moon in my left, and all of Arab's wealth at my feet, I will still not denounce the Kalma Sharif. Huh? I'm his grandson. Your little piddly little money, your piddly little wealth and your titles, do you think I care about them? So what he did, he gathered all his family and he left. 72 members of his family, he left to them and said, come on daughters, grandchildren, let's go. We're not going to live here anymore. Now why was it important for Yazid to have Imam Hussein live in Medina Sharif? Why was it important? Can anyone tell me? Chi?
In case they have war, they won't have to go two places.
In case they have war, no. But he left not for war. He just left with his family. Publicity? No.
مثله حسنك ما رأينا قد يا وجه السرور يا نبي سلام عليك يا